إذا يبقى معنا بعد أن تعلمنا ولله الحمد الأشياء النجسة، يبقى معنا إزالة النجاسة. كيف تزال النجاسة؟ سواء كانت على الثوب أو في المكان في الأرض مثلا. نعم.
So the thing that remains with us now is how do we clean ourselves from this impurity if, for example, the impurity or something which is dirty has affected our clothing. How do we now clean the clothing? Or if it's something which is on the floor, how do we clean it?
إزالة النجاسة على ثلاثة أقسام.
Cleaning yourself or cleaning these matters or removing the impurity is three types.
نجاسة مغلظة ونجاسة مخففة ونجاسة متوسطة.
So we have three types of impurities which affect our clothes or the ground, for example. The najasa, the impurity which is very severe, the impurity which is just a little amount and it's not as severe, and that which is in between these two.
يعني نجاسة فيها تخفيف ونجاسة يعني ليس فيها تخفيف ونجاسة فيها توسط بين هذا وبين هذا. نعم.
So we have a type of impurity which is light and little and not that serious, and we have another type of impurity which is very serious and very heavy. And then we have the third type of impurity, which is between both of these types.
النجاسة المغلظة هي نجاسة الكلب إذا ولغ في الإناء، يعني أراد الشرب، لأنه لا يشرب الكلب إلا بإخراج اللسان، وبهذا يكون هذا السائل الذي في الإناء نجس. يراق كل ما في هذا الإناء ويغسل سبع مرات أولاهن بالتراب. نعم.
The heavy or the severe form of impurity, which we mentioned the first type, the most heavy and severe form of impurity, this is when a dog comes and the dog drinks the water in a utensil. Because when the dog drinks the water in a utensil, he only does so by moving his tongue and placing his tongue in the water, and therefore his saliva mixes with the water. So therefore, in this type of situation, the impurity is like a severe, heavy type of impurity. So what do we have to do? We have to spill the water, all of the water, and then we have to wash and clean the utensil seven times, and the first of these seven times, a person uses soil. So use soil first, clean it, and then after that, six more times with water.
نعم. إذن هذه هي النجاسة المغلظة. نجاسة الكلب إذا ولغ في الإناء، شرب من إناء، يراق كل ما فيه ويغسل سبع مرات أولاهن بالتراب، يضع في الأولى التراب، ثم بعد هذا يضع الأولى ويغسل الثاني والثالثة والرابعة حتى يتم سبع غسلات. نعم.
So for example, if we have this utensil and it is full of water, and a dog comes and he starts drinking from this water, he enters his tongue into this water and starts drinking, then now this is the severe type of impurity. So we have to spill the water that was inside here, wash this first with the soil, use soil and clean it, and then six more times we wash this with water. So we have seven times we have cleaned this. Once with soil and then six more times of water.
هذا القسم الأول، النجاسة المغلظة لابد فيها من سبع مرات ولهن بالتراب. نعم.
This is the most severe and heaviest type of impurity as mentioned. We wash it seven times, we clean it seven times, the first time with soil.
الثانية النجاسة المخففة.
And then the second type of impurity is that which is not as severe or which is very light.
النجاسة المخففة يجزئ فيها رش الماء فقط، أن تأتي بالماء وترش عليه، مثاله يعني هكذا ترش هكذا رش، هذا يجزئ في إزالة النجاسة المخففة، رش الماء فقط. نعم.
And then we have the second type of impurity, which is a less severe or very light form of impurity. In this situation, it's permitted for a person to, for example, if there's impurity here, as the Sheikh did, a person spills a little amount of water on it, on the impurity, and this is enough for us to clean this impurity. This now is considered as being clean.
نعم. أو يأخذ مثلاً شيء من الماء في يده وينضح هكذا على النجاسة، هذه تكفي في إزالة هذه النجاسة، لأن هذه نجاسة مخففة. نعم.
Or for example, a person can take a little amount of water on his hand and then just shower or throw the drops of water on the impurity. Because it's نجاسة مخففة because it's a less form or a very light and weakened form of impurity, then this is enough.
النجاسة المتوسطة.
صبر صبر في هذا. صبر النجاسة.
Say again.
صبر ضد النجاسة.
نوع يعني نوع الجنازة يعني.
في دواء لا يباع في السهلية. يسميه العلماء أصدرين. أصبر الآن نشرح واحد واحد. ما انتهينا إلى الآن. نعم.
So we're going to explain what you're saying.
نعم. إذا هذه نجاسة مخففة يجزي فيها النضح رش الماء فقط. نعم هذه المخففة.
So when we have this light or very weak form of impurity, then it's enough for us just to throw, spill some water on there or just to throw some water on there. And this is enough to clean it.
Come on. تتكلم.
Move forward. Don't.
طيب. النجاسة المتوسطة فيها رش الماء مع العصر. وهذا يسميه العلماء غسل. نعم.
And then we have the impurity which is in the middle. I neither is it very heavy and severe like the licking of the dog, and neither is it something which is very, very light. It is something in the middle. In this situation, a person spills water on the impurity like the sheikh did, and then you clean the impurity like this, or you clean the paper, the cloth like this.
Clean عصر الله ما أدري إيش تسمي العصر عصر
نخرج الماء.
أي نعم.
That a person he removes the water like this by squeezing the garment or the cloth, and this the scholars call cleaning the impurity.
مرة أخرى.
So once again.
النجاسة المغلظة سبع مرات ولهن بالتراب نجاسة الكلب إذا ولغ في الإناء.
So the impurity is three types. The first type of impurity is something which is heavy and severe, and that is the drinking or the licking of a dog in a utensil. This we spill the water out and we wash it seven times. The first of these seven times with soil.
نعم. النجاسة المخففة يجزي فيها رش فقط. رش الماء بدون عصر. نعم.
And then the light or most weak form of impurity. And in this, it's enough for us to spill a little bit of water on it or throw drops of water on it, and we don't need to squeeze the water out.
النجاسة المتوسطة لابد فيها من رش مع عصر.
And as for the type of impurity which is in the middle between being very severe and being very light, then we have to pour water on it, on the impurity, and also squeeze and take all the water out of the garment or the cloth where the impurity was.
ما هي النجاسة المخففة؟ هذا سؤال. نعم.
So then, as the brother may Lord ward him and bless him, he asked the question, what is the light form of impurity? What is the najasa mukhaffafa, the impurity which is light and not very severe?
Al-najasa mukhaffafa, thalatha ashiya. Now,
the light or the minor form of physical impurity, it is three things.
Al-awwal,
first,
al-dhakar, الذي يرضع من حليب الأم يعني يرضع من حليب الأم دون الحولين. نعم.
A baby, a male baby, a boy who is under 2 years of age and he's being fed with the milk from his mother, he's being breastfed from his mother, then his urine بولون.
إذا بال على الثوب مثلا على ثوبي الآن أو على بترتي مثلا فماذا أصنع؟ أرش الماء فقط أو أنضح كذا وأمشي أصلي فيه ولا إشكال فيه في البول فقط. ذكر خرج بهذا الأنثى. نعم.
So if this newborn small baby boy under the 2 years of age, and the sheikh said he's a boy, therefore not a girl, he has to be a boy under the 2 years of age, and he's being breastfed with the milk of his mother, if he urinates, for example, on your cloth, or if he urinates on your scarf, for example, then what do? You spill a little bit of water on the urine, or you just throw some droplets of water on the urine, and then you can go pray, and this is enough. You don't need to clean or squeeze the cloth.
Al-ghulam al-dhakar kharaj bihadha al-untha.
So we said a small baby boy, and therefore not a baby girl.
في البول فقط لا في الغائط.
And only in urine, not in excrement.
دون الفطام يعني دون الحولين وغائط الطعام هذا حليب الأم.
And he is under 2 years of age And that in most cases his food is the milk from breastfeeding from his mother.
هذا الأول.
So this is the first type of light impurity.
الثاني المذي. المذي هو سائل ليس له لون كالماء لكن فيه شيء من اللزوجة يخرج عند التفكير. نعم.
And then the second type of very light type of impurity is al-madi. Al-madi is a discharge that comes from a person's private part from the front, and it is a liquid which is often clear. However, it's slightly viscous, and it usually comes about due to a person thinking about intimate desires or having intimate desires.
هذا المذي نجس.
So this discharge or this liquid that comes out from a person's front private parts, then this is najis, this is impure.
ناقض الوضوء لأن تقدم معنا أي خارج من السبيلين ناقض الوضوء.
And it breaks or invalidates a person's ablution, his wudu. Why? Because we have already said that anything that comes out from a person's private parts from the front or the back breaks a person's wudu.
حتى تقطع هذا الخارج من الذكر لابد من غسل الذكر مع الخصيتين.
And in order for yourself, in order for you to totally clean yourself from this discharge, then you have to clean all of your the front private parts, all of it.
إذا نزل جاء شيء من المذي على الثوب مثال يعني جاء مثل هذا نقطة من المذي على السروال مثلا. نعم.
عفوا شيخ. The Sheikh mentioned, just so I'm clear on this, and this is from fiqh, that when this discharge comes out, then a person has to wash all of the front private parts, meaning, akramakumullah, a person washes his penis and also the two testicles, all of it.
نعم. إذا نزلت نقطة على الثوب، هذا نجس الآن وقع على الثوب، نجاسة. كيف تزال هذه النجاسة؟ بالرش فقط، نفح ماء فقط. نعم. هذا القسم الثاني.
If now this discharge from the front, which is called al-madi, if this now, for example, falls upon your clothes or upon your trousers, your inner garments, then how do you clean or purify your clothes from this? Again, because it's najasa mukhaffafa, because it is a minor form or a very light form of impurity, then again, it's enough for a person just to spill a little amount of water on it, on this impurity, or just droplets of water like this.
يعني وهو قادم من المسجد الآن نزل شيء من المذي على سرواله. نعم.
As an example, a person is going to the masjid, or a person is about to pray, and then some of this madi, some of this discharge, it falls on a person's cloth.
انتقض الوضوء.
His wudu has now broken.
لابد أن يغسل الذكر مع الخصيتين.
He now has to wash all of his private part as mentioned.
ويرش على سرواله مكان المكان الذي أصابه هذا المذي ويأتي يصلي بعد أن يتوضأ ولا إشكال فيها.
And then all he has to do is throw some droplets of water or a little bit of water on this impurity, and then he can pray and there's nothing wrong with this. And he makes wudu, and then he prays and there's nothing wrong with this. He makes wudu.
هذا الثاني.
So this is now the second type of minor, very weak form of impurity.
الثالث.
And then the third type is
المني. المني سائل لزج له لون أبيض وله رائحة. نعم. يحصل بعد خروجه فتور وتعب للجسم. نعم. وهو الذي يكون منه الولد بإذن الله سبحانه وتعالى.
And then the third type of najasa mukhaffafa, the weak form of impurity is
سائل.
Is semen. And this semen, it is a sexual discharge from a person's front.
أبيض.
And it is a liquid, it is white.
لزج.
It is viscous.
له رائحة.
And he also has a certain smell.
يحصل له بعد الخروج فتور للجسم.
And this
تعب في الجسم.
And this is after a person during intercourse, you know, there is an effort from his body.
يكون منه الولد بإذن الله سبحانه وتعالى.
And due to this discharge, by the permission of Allah, there is a child.
المني طاهر.
So the semen in itself, it is pure.
لأنه أصل خلق الإنسان.
Because this is the origin of a human being.
لأنه تنادى الرجل مع آخر الأول يقول أن المني طاهر والثاني يقول أن المني نجس. نعم.
So two men, for example, they were arguing. One said that this semen it is pure. The other one said no, it is impure.
فالأول الذي يقول ان المني طاهر يقول تعبت اعلم هذا ان اصله طاهر ويأبى هو الا ان يكون اصله نجس. نعم.
So the first person, he says to the second one, look, you know, I'm fed up, I've become tired. I'm trying to teach this person that semen, it is pure. And he keeps saying, he refuses, and he keeps saying, no, it is najis, it is impure.
المني طاهر.
So therefore, money, semen is pure, طاهر.
ناقض الوضوء.
However, it breaks the wudu.
نعم, بل يجب منه الاغتسال.
And not only does it break the wudu, but a person has to make a ghusl.
لأن موجبات الغسل خروج المني دفقا بلذة خروج المني دفقا يعني أخرج يعني بقوة وبلذة يعني بشهوة. نعم هذا الأول من موجبات الغسل.
And we said it invalidates a person's wudu and a person has to make ghusl because from those things which necessitate a person making ghusl is sexual discharge of semen that comes out due to sexual intercourse and it comes out with force.
سواء خرج المني وهو ناعم أو مستغرق لأنه قد يخرج وهو ناعم بالاحتلال. نعم.
So regardless of if or regardless of whether a person there's a sexual discharge of semen whether he's asleep or awake. For example, he could be having a wet dream. When he's asleep, he still has to make ghusl.
وإسلام الكافر إذا أسلم الكافر يغتسل.
So now we are talking about those things which necessitate us to make ghusl. So the Sheikh said sexual discharge of semen, whether he's awake or asleep, and then a non-Muslim accepting Islam, he has to make a ghusl.
والتقاء الختانين يعني إذا التقى الرجل بزوجته يعني وغاب الذكر في فرج المرأة. نعم.
And also when a male enters into a female, i.e. when the two private parts of the male and the female touch and enter into each other, the part of the male enters into the female.
وموت غير الشهيد. إذا مات عندنا إنسان ماذا نصنع فيه؟ نغسله وجوبا ولا بد من تغسيل الميت إلا الشهيد لا يغسل. نعم.
And also when a person he dies, when a person dies, as long as he does not die as a martyr, as a shaheed, then we have to wash him. So the person who dies and he is not a martyr, not a shaheed, then it is an obligation for us or upon us to wash his body.
ويجب الاغتسال على المرأة إذا طهرت من الحيض والنفاس. هذه موجبات خمسة. نعم.
And also, ghusl is an obligation upon a woman once she is free from her bleeding, from menstruation.
نعم.
So these are the five things which necessitate or obligate ghusl upon us. Five things.
خروج المني.
As we said, the discharge of semen.
التقاء الختانين.
And also the two private parts of a woman, a male and female coming together.
Islam al-Kabir.
And also a non-Muslim accepting Islam.
موت غير الشهيد.
And then also a person dying as long as he's not a shaheed.
المرأة إذا طهرت من الحيض والنفاس.
And the fifth one is a woman who has now purified herself from bleeding in terms of menstruation or postnatal bleeding.
نرجع هنا إلى القسم الثالث من إزالة النجاسة المخففة خروج أن المني إذا وقع على الثوب وقع المني على ثوبك الآن ماذا تصنع؟
So now we go back to what we were discussing before. How do we purify and clean ourselves from the minor form of impurity or the weak time of impurity that comes on your clothing? We said that if a semen, if some semen now falls on your garment, on your clothing, then how do you clean yourself and purify yourself from it?
إذا صلى وعلى ثوبه مني فالصلاة صحيحة من المني طاهر ولا إشكال فيها.
If a person prays and there is some semen on his clothing, then his prayer is correct. Why? Because we have already said that money, it is tahir, it is pure.
لكن السنة إذا كان وقع المني على الثوب وكان رطب فماذا تصنع؟ ترش المني رش نضح وإن كان جار تحط هكذا حتى. نعم.
The sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, or that which is more recommended, is that if some semen is discharged and it falls onto your clothing, then if it is wet, it is still wet, then you throw a little amount of water on it, or you just put some water on it like this. If, however, the semen is dry and it's on your clothing, then you rub it off like this, you rub it off. But if a person prays in that garment with some semen on there, then there's no problem and his prayer is correct and accepted. So we said that the weak form or the light forms of impurity are three things. The urine of a baby boy, he was under the 2 years of age and he hasn't started eating food yet, solids yet. And most likely his nourishment and his food is the milk of his mother.
And we said
secondly, al-madhi, which is that discharge which comes out from a person's private part from the front, it's a clear liquid. And it's mostly due to a person thinking about intimate desires. Again, this is najasa, this is impurity, and a person has to clean his garment from it.
الثالث المني طاهر لكن يستحب أن إذا كان رطب أن ينضح وإذا كان جاف أن يحط نعم.
And also المني, which is a semen. And again, although it is pure and your prayer is correct in that garment, but it's recommended and it's better for a person to shower or throw some drops of water on his clothes, or if it's dry, that he takes it off like this, he rubs it off. But if he prays in that garment and he hasn't washed it, or he hasn't rubbed it off, then his prayer is correct, because we said many this type of discharge, it is pure.
بقيه النجاسات نجاسة متوسطة لا بد من رش الماء مع العصر وبهذا أتممنا إزالة النجاسات.
So every other type of impurity, any other type of impurity which doesn't fit into one of these two categories, then we say it is the middle one, the one which is not as severe and not very light at the same time. And this one, we have to throw some water on it and at the same time squeeze the water out of the garment.
بول الآدمي.
So included in this type is the urine of a human being.
غائط الآدمي.
Excrement of a human being.
بول وروث ما لا يأكل لحمه.
The urine and the excrement or the dung of an animal whose meat is not eaten.
دم الحيض والنفاس.
The blood of حيض and نفاس.
بول الجارية دون الفطام التي تضع حليب الأم.
And also the urine of a little girl, a baby girl who is under the 2 years of age and she's also being breastfed.
رش الماء مع العصر.
As we said, spill a small amount of water on the impurity and then squeeze the water out.
ولا وضع يعني هذا اللباس في غسالة الملابس الحمد لله.
And also if a person places this clothing in a washing machine, then it's enough.
نعم. إذا أخذنا إزالة النجاسات على ثلاثة أقسام. نعم.
So therefore, we have studied and we have understood the washing and cleaning the forms of impurities in these three types.
وقع بول الآدمي أو دم الحيض والنفاس على اللباس. نعم.
Let's say on a garment, the urine of a human being or the blood of a woman's menses, it falls onto a piece of clothing, a garment.
رش الماء وعصر. نعم.
A person then has spilled some water on it and has squeezed the water out.
بقي أثر لون أو ريح لا يضر.
And then after this washing and squeezing the water out, we can still see some after effects of that impurity, meaning there's some discoloring there or there's still some smell there.
لا يضرها لأنه أتى بما فرض الله سبحانه وتعالى عليه من رش الماء والعصر لا يضرها.
Then there's nothing wrong with this. It doesn't affect the person. Why? Because the person has completed and fulfilled that which Allah has obligated upon him.
ذكرنا في الدرس الماضي ما تعلق بصفة الوضوء والتيمم والاغتسال. ذكرنا أن الاغتسال على قسمين. نعم.
We mentioned in the previous lesson, which was after Fajr, we mentioned the description of wudu, the description of a person making ablution. We mentioned the description of a person making tayammum, and we also mentioned the description of a person performing ghusl. And we said that al ghusl, a person taking a ritual bath, is of two types.
يبقى معنا المسح على الخفين المسح على الجوربين وكل ما يلبس على الرجلين. نعم.
And now the thing which we are left with is wiping over the khuf, which is the leather socks, or wiping over the socks which are made out of cloth, which we are all wearing now, or wiping over anything which is worn on the foot.
شروط المسح على الجوربين على الخفين. نعم. شروط لابد للمسح على الجوربين أو الخفين أو المسح أكرمكم الله الآن على هذه الجزمة. شوف.
نعم.
لا النعل لا الثانية.
جزمة. أحذية.
شوز. لا ليس الحذاء المفتوح هذا المغلق.
إيه شوز ترينر.
شوز. إذا المسح على الجوارب. المسح على كل ما يلبس على الرجلين وانتهى الأمر. نعم.
So now we need to understand the conditions of a person wiping over the khufain, the leather socks, or the socks which are made out of fabric or clothing, or shoes or trainers, the condition of wiping over anything which is worn on a person's foot.
حتى نمسح عليها لابد من شروط.
So in order now for us to wipe over it and not wash the foot in wudu, there are certain conditions that have to be fulfilled.
الشرط الأول أن يكون لبس هذا على طهارة أي على وضوء كامل وغسل الرجلين بالماء. نعم.
The first condition is that before a person puts this on, whether it's his shoes or his trainers or his leather socks or the fabric socks, before he put it on, then he has to be in a state of purity, of tahara, and he must have washed his feet with water.
أن تكون طاهرة لا نجسة. نعم.
So a person has to be أن تكون يعني خوفا.
هذا الذي يلبس على رجلين طاهر لا نجس.
And also the second condition now is that which you are wearing on your foot in itself it has to be pure and clean and not najis, not impure.
أن تكون ساترة لغالب العضو يعني تستر غالب الرجل حتى وإن بدأ شيء من الكعبين لا يضرب مثل هذه الجوارب الحديثة عندنا اليوم تكون أسفل من الكعبين هذه لا يضرب يمسح علينا أن تستر غالب القدمين. نعم.
And also that which you are wearing it has to cover most of your foot. The most of your foot has to be covered by that which you are wearing. So even now these new socks, what they call the ankle socks, and they come over some of the ankle, then this you can also make mas'h over. Why? Because they cover most of the foot.
لكن المسح على هذه ما تسمى النعلين عندنا لا لأنها ليست ساترة الغالب العضو هذا يمسح عليها. نعم.
But for example, a person wiping over sandals or slippers, we can't wipe over them because they don't cover most of the foot. They show most of the foot.
الشرط الذي بعد هذا أن يكون المسح في الوقت لا بعد الوقت. والوقت عندنا يوم وليلة للمقيم وثلاثة أيام بالعليا للمسافر 24 ساعة للمقيم و72 ساعة للمسافر. نعم.
And then the fourth condition is that when you're wiping over this thing that you're wearing over your feet, then you have to do it within the limits of the times that we have been told or legislated. Meaning, as for a person who is resident and living in one single place, then he has one day and one night in order for him to wipe over the khuf or the leather sock or the fabric socks. So he has 24 hours. And a person who is a traveler, he's traveling somewhere, he's on a journey, what is the distance of a journey? Then he has 3 days and three nights, meaning he has 72 hours in which he can keep wiping over without washing it.
نعم. الشرط الخامس أن يكون المسح في الحدث الأصغر لا في الحدث الأكبر. نعم.
And then the fifth condition is that you can only make mask, you can only wipe instead of washing when you're in a state of minor impurity, not major impurity, not hadith al-akbar.
أن يكون لبس الجوربين أو الخفين على طهارة كاملة ويكون غسل القدمين بالماء أو رجلين بالماء.
طهارة يعني
وضوء. نعيد. نعم وضوء كامل. نعم.
So therefore, the five conditions of a person wiping over that which he's wearing on his feet, whether it's the leather socks or the fabric socks or the shoes or the trainers, is number one, that person must be in a state of ablution, in a state of purity. He must have washed his feet with water.
الثاني أن تكون طاهرة لا نجسة.
And then that which you are wearing, the second condition, that which you are wearing on your feet or on your foot, then this in itself must be pure and not impure.
ساتر الغالب العضو.
And also that it must complete and it must cover most of the foot. It must cover most of the foot.
حتى وإن كانت من قماش خفيف يعني حتى وإن كان وراء شيء من القدم من وراء هذا الساتر. نعم.
Even if the fabric socks, for example, are very light, as long as it is covering the foot, as long as it covers most of the foot, then you can wipe over it.
And يمسح في الوقت.
And also that person only wipes in the time frame that has been provided.
أن يكون المسح في الحدث الأصغر للأكبر.
And then the person, his impurity is only the minor form of impurity and not the major form of impurity for which a person has to make ghusl.
الآن إذا كان على أحد أعضاء الوضوء جبيرة يعني جبس أو يعني لفافة شاش أو ما إلى ذلك. نعم.
Let's say if a person is now on one of his body parts which he has to wash for wudu. Let's say he's wearing a bandage, for example, or it's been covered by something which has been tied to it, like a bandage.
نقول لابد أن تنزع هذا وتغسل العضو هذا بالماء.
Now we say to him that you have to remove this thing, or you have to remove this bandage and wash your this body part with water when you're making wudu.
قال لا أستطيع. لا أستطيع أن أنزع هذا لأنه هذه الجبيرة الآن لو نزعها يحصل له ضرر. فقال أنا الآن مضطر إلى هذا ما أستطيع أن أنزع. نعم.
And let's say if this person says that I'm not able to remove my bandage because obviously if I remove my bandage then it's going to hurt me or there's going to be more of an injury, so I'm not able to remove this bandage from my arm, for example.
إذا لابد أن ينزع ويغسل. نعم. أولا هذا المرحلة الأولى عنده إنه لابد أن ينزع أي شيء على أعضاء الوضوء ويغسل العضو. نعم.
So again, in the first situation, we say that a person has to remove his bandage or remove this covering and wash his body part that he has to wash it in wudu.
قال ما أستطيع يحصل علي ضرر من نزع هذا.
If he says that it's not possible for me to remove my bandage because it's going to harm me or injure me or cause me more pain.
فماذا يصنع الآن؟ يمسح عليها كاملة. نعم.
And then what does he do in this situation? He then wipes over the bandage, just wipes over with the wet hand, all over the bandage.
قال ما أستطيع أن أمسح عليها. هذا المرحلة الثالثة.
And now we have a third situation where he says that I'm not even able to wipe over it. I can't even wipe over my bandage because it might cause some harm or some injury or some pain.
يعني مثاله لديه هنا جرح وهذا الجرح مكشوف. نعم.
As an example, let's say that here on a piece of his arm he has been cut or he has an injury on a specific piece of his arm.
نقول لابد من غسل جميع العضو مع الجرح. نعم.
We would say, normally we would say that look, you have to wash all of your arm including that which is cut.
قال لا أستطيع.
He says, I'm not able to do this.
نقول امسح عليه.
Then we say to him, just wipe over the cut with wet hands. Don't wash it, just wipe over it.
قال لا أستطيع.
He says, I'm not able to do so.
فماذا يصنع؟ الآن يتوضأ وضوء كامل دون هذا الموضع الذي فيه الجرح الذي لا يستطيع أن يغسل أو يمسح عليه. نعم.
So what does he do? We say to him that perform all of your wudu, but don't wipe or touch or wash that part of your arm with water. Leave it alone.
فإذا انتهى من وضوئه.
And once he has now finished from his ablution,
يتيمم.
Then he makes tayammum.
بسم الله.
He says Bismillah.
ينوي.
He has an intention in his heart.
بقلبه ثم يسمي.
He has an intention in his heart. Then he says Bismillah.
يضرب ضربة واحدة على الأرض.
He places his hand upon the earth once.
ثم الوجه.
And
يضرب إحدى كفيه ثم الوجه ثم ظاهر اليمنى ثم ظاهر اليسرى.
And then after doing this, he then wipes his face once and then the outer part of outer hand.
فهذا التيمم يقوم مقام ترك غسل هذا الذي لم يغسل من أعضاء الوضوء. نعم.
So now this tayammum of his, this comes in the place of him not washing over, wiping that cut or that bandage.
يبقى معنا في هذا الكتاب ما تعلق بالحيض. نعم.
And now in this chapter, the chapter of al-tahara, purification, the thing which remains with us is that which relates to al-hayd, which are the bleeding of women during the monthly period, and also an-nifas, which is post-natal bleeding.
Al-asl fil-mar'a, هل الأصل فيها الطهارة أو الحيض؟
So the base or the origin, the base ruling or the origin of a woman is that is she pure or impure? Who knows?
الطهارة نعم. فإذا شكت المرأة هل هي حائض أم لا؟ فالأصل عندنا الطهارة دائما إذا نبني على هذا. نعم.
Is of course that she is pure. So if a woman, for example, she doubts in herself that have I bled from my menses or have I not bled from my menses, we say we go back to the origin. The ruling is ruling of the origin that she is pure. So in this way, in fiqh, we always do this. We always go back to the original ruling.
إذا نزل الدم المعتاد عندها المعروف أن دم الحيض فهي حائض وإن لم ينزل حتى وكان لديها آلام في البطن أو كذا فالأصل عندنا طهارة. نعم.
If she knows that this blood which has now been discharged from her, it is blood of the menses, then we say that yes, this is impurity. She is now in a state of impurity. If, however, she's not sure or she's doubting or she doesn't have certainty that she has bled, even if she has, for example, pains in her stomach, pains in her abdomen, then we say that she is in a state of purity because we go back to the origin that she is pure.
الناس النساء انقسموا في الحيض إلى ثلاثة أقسام.
Women, in terms of their periodic bleeding during the month, then they come into three categories, three different types of women.
وبهذا يعني نستطيع أن نعرف يعني هل هذه المرأة يعني طاهرة أو حائض. نعم.
And by knowing these three types or categories of women in terms of the periodic bleeding, then we can know that is she in a state of حيض, in a state of menstruation, or is she pure.
القسم الأول.
So the first type of woman or the first type of bleeding.
أن تكون المرأة لها عادة معلومة وأيام معلومة من كل شهر هجري. نعم.
Is the first type of woman is that she knows she has certain days in a certain part of the Islamic month in which she has her bleeding.
يعني يأتيها الحيض ستة أيام في كل شهر هجري في كل أول شهر هجري. نعم.
As an example, the woman knows that in every Islamic month, at the beginning of every Islamic month, at the beginning, the first few days of the Islamic month, she knows that she bleeds for 5 days in every Islamic month at the beginning.
هذه تسمى عندنا معتادة أي لها عادة معلومة. نعم.
So this type of woman with this type of bleeding in fiqh she's called المعتادة, meaning a woman who knows habitually that she has this type of bleeding for this many days in this part of the month.
فتجلس هذه العادة دائما لا تصلي ولا تصوم على ما سيأتي معنا يعني. نعم. وما زاد عن هذا لو جاءها الدم بعد هذه الأيام فهو استحارة. نعم. وسيأتي معنا ذكر استحارة. نعم.
So in this type of situation, this woman, during those normal days, those 5 days of bleeding, for example, then she is in the state of al-hayd, periodic monthly bleeding, in a state of impurity, and therefore, as we're going to discuss, she doesn't pray, she doesn't fast, and so on and so forth. If now there is any bleeding more than those days, if let's say her periodic bleeding is normally for 5 days, now she has a 6th and a 7th and an 8th day of bleeding, then the other bleeding isn't hayd, it's not her periodic bleeding which is najas, rather it's istihada. And we're going to discuss this second type of bleeding called istihada.
إذن هذه المعتادة تجلس الأيام التي اعتادت عليها وما زاد عن هذا تصلي وتصوم وتصنع كل شيء. نعم.
So this is the first type of woman with this type of bleeding. She has habitual bleeding. She knows that she bleeds her monthly periodic bleeding at this time of the month for this many days. In that time, in those days, then she has hayd and she doesn't fast and she doesn't pray and so on and so forth. If, however, she carries on bleeding after those days, then she carries on with praying and fasting and so on and so forth.
القسم الثاني من النساء.
The second type of woman with regards to menses.
ليس لها عادة معلومة. ليس لها عادة معلومة في كل شهر. يعني يأتيها الدم أحيانا في أول الشهر وأحيانا في الوسط وأحيانا في آخر الشهر. نعم.
Is the type of woman who doesn't have this type of habitual bleeding, meaning that sometimes she bleeds for a number of days at the beginning of the month. Sometimes she bleeds for a number of days in the middle of the month, and sometimes she bleeds for a number of days at the end of the month.
لكنها تستطيع أن تميز دم الحيض من دم الاستحاضة أو دم الفساد. نعم.
But she's able to distinguish the blood that she's bleeding. She's able to distinguish between her blood, the blood of her monthly period, and other blood which is istihada.
كيف تميز دم الاستحاضة عن غيره؟ نعم.
How can this woman distinguish between the blood of her monthly periods and other bleeding?
الآن عندما تجرح الآن.
When a person, for example, is cut or injured.
ينزل دم ذو لون أحمر. ودم الاستحاضة دم أسود. هذا تميز.
Now, one of the ways is that when a person is cut, the blood that comes out is red. You can see that it's red blood. As for the blood of hay, of the monthly periodic blood bleeding, then it is black in color.
عندما تجرح الآن ينزل دم له رائحة؟ لا، في الغالب أنه ليس له رائحة. لكن دم الحي له رائحة كريهة. نعم.
When a person is cut in normal bleeding, then the blood that comes out, it doesn't have like a strong smell or a pungent smell. As for the bleeding of hayd, of menses, then it has a smell to it.
الآن عندما تجرح، عندما ينزل الدم، متجمد أو يسير؟ يسير. بعد هذا يتجمد. دم الحيض عكس هذا، ينزل أول شيء قطع جامد، ثم بعد هذا يسير. نعم.
And also when a person bleeds from a cut, then the blood that comes out, is it something that flows, or is it something which is like almost like a solid? It's something that flows quite easily. And this is opposite to al-hayd. When it comes to hayd, or the bleeding of the menses, then when it first comes out, it's like a solid almost. And then after that, it might become flowing.
إذن هذا هو القسم الثاني من النساء أنها تميز، تفرق بين دم الحيض وغير الحيض. نعم.
And this therefore is the second type of woman with regards to her menses, that she is able to distinguish that she doesn't know when she bleeds. Sometimes she bleeds at the beginning or the middle or the end for a certain number of days, but she can distinguish between the different types of blood. She can distinguish between the blood of the menses, and she can distinguish between her normal bleeding.
فالذي تميز أن دم حيض هذا معناه أنها في هذا الوقت هي حائض، تترك الصيام والصلاة، ما سيأتي معنا من الأشياء التي تتركها، وغير هذا مستحاضة تصنع كل شيء. نعم.
So as long as she can distinguish between the different types of bleeding, as long as she knows that this bleeding is my bleeding of the menses, then in these particular days, whenever they come, then she is now haid. She is now in her menses. So she doesn't pray, she doesn't fast, and we're going to discover this. Any other type of bleeding, which she knows isn't haid, then this is normal bleeding, and she carries on doing whatever she wants.
Now, القسم الثالث من النساء.
And then we have a third type of woman in relation to her menses.
القسم الأول لها عادة معلومة تسمى معتادة. نعم.
He said that the first type of woman is a معتادة, i.e. a woman who knows her habitual bleeding at this time of the month for this many days.
الثانية مميزة تميز دم الحيض من غيره. نعم.
And then the second type of woman is called a مميزة, somebody or a woman who can distinguish between her bleeding of her menses and her normal bleeding.
الثالثة متحيرة, يعني احتارت هي في نفسها وحيرتها معها, ما نستطيع. هل لك عادة معلومة؟ تقول لا. هل تميز دم الحيض من غيره؟ تقول لا. طيلة الشهر ينزل عليها الدم, فماذا نصنع بها؟ نعم.
And then we have a third type of woman, and she is called متحيرة. And this is a woman who she just does not know. Neither does she know, neither does anybody know. So she doesn't have like a habitual bleeding, sometimes at the beginning, end for so many days, and neither can she distinguish between her different types of bleeding. Sometimes she might bleed throughout the whole month, and she doesn't know, she can't distinguish whether this is menses or normal bleeding.
فإذا جاءتنا مرأة تسأل.
So if now this type of woman, she comes and she asks us,
تسأل عن الحيض.
She's asking regarding her menses.
هل أنت معتادة على أيام معينة في كل شهر؟ تقول نعم. إذن هي معتادة تبقى هذه الأيام, ما زاد عن هذا فهو استحاضة. نعم.
So this woman comes and she asks whether she is a haid, whether she's falling into the category of being a haid. We say to her that, do you have habitual bleeding? Do you know that your menses are this time of the month for this many days? If she says yes, then we say that in these days you are now a haid.
وإذا قالت أنها ليس لها عادة معلومة, نقول تميز قالت نعم أنا أميز فهي مميزة الذي تميزه حيض فهو حيض وإلا فهي تصنع كل شيء نعم
and if she doesn't have this habitual bleeding but she's somebody who's able to distinguish between the different types of blood then we say that as long as you know that this blood is now حيض is a blood of menses then you are in that state of being a حائض and if it is any other bleeding then it is normal bleeding and it is not حيض
وإذا قالت لنا أنها ليس لها عادة معلومة ولا تمييز صالح يعني ما تميز هذا الدم من هذا الدم فهي متحيرة نعم
and if she says that neither do I have any habitual type of bleeding and neither can I distinguish between the different types of blood then she is متحيرة somebody who totally does not know whether she's in her menses or not
نقول لها بهذه المتحيرة نقول لابد أن ترجعي إلى النساء من أقربائك إلى أختها وأمها وخالتها كم عندهم أيام الحيض؟ تقول أيام الحيض عندهم ستة أيام مثلاً نعم
We say to her that you have to go back and ask your mother, your sisters and your aunties i.e. the females from amongst your relatives and your family and you ask them and you should know about them how many days of periodic bleeding in a month do they have? How many days?
ستة أيام مثلاً قالت أن عندهم الحيض ستة أيام نعم
So let's say she says that my mother, my sisters and my aunties every month they have 6 days of bleeding of the monthly period
فنقول لها لابد أن تبقي ستة أيام من أول كل شهر هجري تترك فيها الحيض والصيام وغيرها تترك فيها الصلاة والصيام على ما سيأتي وبقية الشهر تصلي حتى وقرأة الدم وتصوم الأشكال فيها نعم
We say to her that the first 6 days of the Islamic month then you have to consider yourself as being in a state of حيض being in a state of monthly periodic bleeding and then for those first 6 days of every Islamic month you leave off fasting, you leave off praying and we're going to cover this. As for the other days, the 7th, 8th and the other days of the Islamic month, then even if you're bleeding throughout then this isn't the bleeding of the menses and you carry on praying and fasting and the other matters.
نعم. أعلم النساء في هذا الباب أعلم الناس في هذا الباب النساء. وهذا من نعم الله علينا أن لا نحي والحمد لله. نعم.
The most knowledgeable or the most aware of people regarding this subject area is the women themselves. And from the blessings of Allah upon us as men is that we don't go through this type of periodic bleeding.
الذي يكون محدث حدث أصغر يعني خرج منه ريح أو بول غائط أو ريح نعم
A person
من عليه حدث أصغر
A person who is in a form of minor impurity meaning he has urinated or he has answered the call of nature or he has passed wind as an example
يحرم عليه
then it's not permissible for him
أن يصلي
to pray
أو يطوف بالبيت
to make طواف around the كعبة
أو يمس المصحف
or to touch a مصحف touch a physical copy of the Quran
إذا من عليه حدث أصغر يحرم عليه ثلاثة أشياء نعم
So therefore the person who is in a minor form of impurity three things are not permitted for him he's not allowed to do three things
الصلاة
prayer
والطواف ومس المصحف
prayer making طواف around the Kaaba and touching the Quran
أراد أن يصلي أو يطوف ومس المصحف نقول توضأ واصنع هذه الأشياء الثلاثة
So this person He now wants to pray, or he wants to make tawaf, or he wants to touch the Quran, a copy of the Quran. We say to him, go make wudu, and then you can do these things.
ويحرم على من عليه حدث أكبر كنزول مني مثلا نزل منه المني يحرم عليه نعم.
And as for the person who is in a state of major impurity, the hadith al-akbar, for example, he has a discharge of semen, then he's not allowed to.
يحرم عليه هذه الأشياء الثلاثة الصلاة والطواف ومس المصحف. نعم.
Then firstly, he's not allowed to do those three things, i.e. he's not allowed to pray, and he's not allowed to make tawaf, and he's not allowed to touch a copy of the Qur'an.
يحرم على قراءة القرآن.
And also, it's not permitted for him to recite the Qur'an. يعني بدون المس. هذا القصد.
الأول الذي حدث الأصغر هذا لا يمس المصحف لكن يقرأ القرآن بغير وضوء ولا أشكال به، لكن من عليه حدث أكبر لا يمس المصحف ولا يقرأ شيء من القرآن، لا قليل ولا كثير.
So just to clarify, a person who is in a minor state of impurity, then he can recite the Quran from his memorization, but he can't touch the Mus'haf. As for the person who is in a state of major impurity, then neither can he touch the Mus'haf, the Quran, and neither can he recite the Quran even off the top of his head.
وَلَا يَلْبَثْ فِي الْمَسْجِدِ إِلَّا إِذَا أَرَادَ أَنْ يَبْقَ فِي الْمَسْجِدِ وَهُوَ جُنُبٌ يَتَوَضَّأ وَيَبْقَ فِي الْمَسْجِدِ. هذا ليس من باب رفع الجنابة ولكن من باب التخفيف، يخفف من أثر الجنابة إذا أراد أن يبقى في المسجد. نعم.
And also a person who is in a major state of impurity, then he does not sit or stay in the masjid, unless he needs to sit and stay in the masjid, so he goes and he makes wudu. Now this ablution that he makes, this wudu that he makes, this doesn't mean that now he isn't in the state of major impurity. It doesn't mean he can pray, for example. But
يعني.
It means that it has lessened the level or the seriousness of this impurity.
هذا الأخ يعمل في هذا المسجد.
So for example, this brother, he actually works in this masjid. He works in the masjid.
وهو الآن عليه جنابة عليه اغتسال لأنه نزل منه مني. نعم.
And he's in a state of major impurity. He's in a state of janaba because of a sexual discharge.
وراد يدخل المسجد لحضور الدرس مثلا.
And now he wanted to enter into the masjid in order to listen to a lesson, for example.
أو النظافة.
Or because he works and he cleans the masjid.
نقول ما تدخل المسجد حتى تغتسل ثم بعد هذا تدخل.
So we say to him that don't enter into the masjid unless you make a ghusl first and then you enter into the masjid.
أو توضأ وتبقى في المسجد لا إشكال في هذا لكن لا يستطيع أن يصلي أو يقرأ القرآن وما إلى ذلك. نعم.
Or we say to him that go make wudu and then you can sit or work or clean in the masjid, but you're still in a state of major impurity, so you can't recite the Quran, you can't pray, and so on and so forth.
مرة أخرى.
So one more time.
الذي عليه حدث أصغر.
The person who is in a state of minor impurity.
لا يصلي ولا يطوف ولا يمس المصحف.
He doesn't pray, he doesn't make tawaf, and he doesn't touch the copy of the Quran.
يبقى القرآن ولا إشكال.
But he can recite the Quran without touching it.
ويبقى في المصحف المسجد ولا إشكال.
And he can remain in the masjid and there's nothing wrong with this.
من عليه حدث أكبر اغتسال.
As for the person who is in a major state of impurity in janaba, then he has to make a ghusl.
لا يصلي ولا يطوف ولا يمس المصحف. نعم.
Then neither does he pray, neither does he make tawaf, neither does he touch a copy of the Quran.
ولا يقرأ شيء من القرآن.
And neither does he recite anything of the Quran.
ولا يصح له أن يبقى في المسجد إلا إذا توضأ.
And neither is he allowed to stay or reside in the masjid unless he makes wudu.
الحائض والنفساء.
As for those women who are in a state of periodic monthly bleeding or postnatal bleeding.
احرم عليها الأشياء كلها التي ذكرناها. لا تصلي.
Then all of these things which are mentioned, then also they are not allowed to do it. So she doesn't pray.
ولا تطوف.
She doesn't pray while she is bleeding. Another does she make tawaf.
ولا تمس المصحف.
Another does she touch a copy of the Quran.
ولا تدخل إلى المسجد.
Another does she enter into the masjid.
ولها أن تقرأ القرآن.
Another does she recite the Quran. Another does she recite the Quran.
ولا تصوم.
Another does she fast.
ويحرم وقتها.
And also it's impermissible for a person to have intercourse with her.
يعني إذا عندنا ثلاث درجات.
So therefore we have three levels.
حدث أصغر ثلاث أشياء.
A person who is in a state of minor impurity, three things that person can't do.
حدث أكبر خمس أشياء.
And a person who is in the major state of impurity, five things that person cannot do.
الحائض والنفساء يحرم عليها هذه الأشياء كلها إلا قراءة القرآن. نعم.
As for the woman who is in her menses or postnatal bleeding, then all of these things are impermissible for her except reciting the Quran.
ومع أنها لا تصوم.
And also she does not fast.
ولا توطأ.
And neither is a person allowed to have intercourse with her.
ولا تطلق.
I know that you should to be divorced. You're not allowed to divorce in this state.
والله أعلم صلى الله عليه وسلم محمد وآله وصحبه وسلم. جزاكم الله خير.
جزاك الله خير. جزاك الله خير.
And just to clarify, the next lesson is in مركز فاطمة.
إن شاء الله الدرس القادم بعد صلاة العصر يا إخوة رجال ونساء في مركز فاطمة الساعة السادسة تماما. 6 o'clock في فاطمة ستار شاء الله.
نصلي هنا ولا
في المركز؟ نصلي هنا.
مركزين.
نصلي في مركز السماء. الصلاة الخامسة بس. جزاكم الله خير بارك الله فيكم صلى الله عز وجل يجزاك بجزاك حسناتك وحسنات الشيخ ان شاء الله
الله يبارك
قبل الله منكم شر الاولاد جعل الله واياكم الذين يستمعون الصلاه